H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
All right, guys, welcome to the session on Friday, that is today. And let us do a recap of what we did on Wednesday. Yes, so we started with what are the prerequisites and which are needed for you to start the training on Selenium or for you to begin with testing on Selenium. Okay, so you need to know basic framework, testing processes and frameworks. You need to know at least one of the programming languages, and you should know have the knowledge about browsers. Now the tools that you will need will be Java, an editor, and Selenium WebDriver. Okay, Selenium IDE, Selenium WebDriver, and Selenium Grid if you are working with Grid. Okay. Now these are the four components of Selenium: IDE, WebDriver, RC, and Grid. The other day we saw what is Selenium IDE and Selenium WebDriver. Today we'll just have a quick look at Selenium RC and Grid. Okay, and then we will move on to downloading Java. We start with the downloads today, softwares which we need initially to download, okay, to start a course. Now in Selenium IDE, as I told you, it's a very simple tool. It's a playback tool. People who are looking, you know, what is, who want to know what actually is an automation testing, were very simple test cases to be executed. There is not much complexity in it, okay. And they, you know, they want to do automation. They are aspiring to be an automation tester. IDE is the best tool to go for it. I showed you a small demo also about it. We learn in detail about the tool during our training. All right. Now IDE here stands for Integrated Development Environment. Yeah, so it's a record and playback tool. It's important thing is that you can download this tool only on Chrome and Firefox browsers. Okay, earlier if you would see 2-3 years back, IDE was available only for Firefox browser. Now they have made it available for Chrome also. So slowly I think they would explore the other browsers too. And you can create and edit your test cases. And also you can create test suites also, which are set of test cases together. Group your test cases together and execute them. That also is possible using Selenium IDE. Alright. Next, we looked at the major component of Selenium, which is Selenium WebDriver. This is where our major training also is focused on. We'll be spending most of our time learning Selenium WebDriver. It is the automation framework which will allow us to execute our test cases against different browsers. All of our testing, wherever it is concentrated, we can do it with the help of Selenium WebDriver. For this, you need a programming language. Okay, you can learn any one of these programming languages like Java, .NET, PHP, Python, Perl, and Ruby. Alright, so Java is what we have picked up, and we are going to learn Java. Now, WebDriver, as I told you, is very fast. Okay, and it, as it directly interacts with the browser. Some of the tools, if you say, let's say APM only, okay, what happens in them? You have the tool here, one, and then you have another tool, a server over here. You have a client, and you have a separate server, and then the final application. So the request goes to the server, server sends a request to the browser, and then it waits for the responses. So that tool may become slow. Here, the tool itself, it directly interacts with the browser. It's very fast. Okay, it also interacts with the elements on the page in a realistic way. And there are API commands. WebDriver is built up of API commands only, guys. You need to learn these API commands. I'm going to teach you all of these commands during our training. And that will make our automation much easier. So after that, we saw the advantages of Selenium WebDriver. One of the major advantages is that you can download Selenium on Windows, Linux, Mac, any operating system. Okay, it is free tool. You can easily download and use it. Okay, and you can choose any one of the programming language and execute your test cases. It's very popular. Okay, it supports all the browsers and also parallel execution. One important thing is that it uses less hardware resources in your machine when compared to loadrunner, QTP, RPT. So if you're working with loadrunner and QTP and your machine is not that huge on the memory, then it makes the machine very slow. APM is one of those tools also. It makes it not APM, actually it is the mobile applications which you download, those make your system very slow. Okay. In APM, if you're working, you will have to download the tool, you will also have to download the server. So you have to start the server and then start your testing tool. Okay, it's a little complex there. But with Selenium, nothing is complex. You just need to download the tool. Ouch, sorry. You need to just download the tool and start our testing. The tool will take care of everything. Okay, that's one of the reasons I keep on telling that it's gaining much and much popularity. Okay, one is that it is very free, it's free of cost. We don't have to pay anything. And then secondly, it does not use much of your resources and it's providing you most of your testing targets. Alright, so let's look at the third section of Selenium, third component, which is Selenium RC. There's no slide about it because Selenium RC stands for, just a second, guys. Let's take a sheet here. Selenium RC. There was a sheet where I was actually writing all your notes. No problem, I'll find it. Selenium RC. So here RC stands for remote control. Selenium remote control. So guys, know that this is outdated tool. It is an outdated tool. Nobody uses it. We don't have to learn about it. Okay. This is only there to maintain projects which were created before 2008. So when Selenium came into market in 2004, it came with IDE, RC and Grid. Okay. RC was actually used for executing our test cases, for building scripts, for enhancing our scripts, for building frameworks. Okay. In 2008, it was outdated and taken over by WebDriver. So WebDriver was introduced in 2008. Okay. Now all the tasks what RC used to do in a better way, WebDriver is doing it. And it's much more powerful when compared to RC. It has much more features when compared to RC. Okay. And so it's, if we don't learn it, it's only available to maintain projects created before 2008. Okay. If anyone is actually, they've done automation with Selenium before 2008, only those projects, it's still there. Okay. But I do hardly think any should be there. Not sure. Maybe some unit testing should be there. All right. So that is Selenium RC, remote control. They ask you during interviews also sometimes. Okay. This is the fourth component, which is Selenium Grid. Okay. It's also part of the Selenium set of tools and it specializes in running multiple test cases across different browsers, operating systems and machine in parallel. Guys, please pay attention here. Grid is a very... it's a little complex tool when compared to WebDriver and IDE. Okay, what does Grid do? You don't have to write scripts here. You don't have to execute, or rather, I'll not say you don't have to create your test cases here. That will be done in WebDriver. Once your script is working fine, same test case if you want to execute in Windows machine, in Mac machine, and Linux machine, and you want to execute it in different browsers, and you want to do it in different machines. Let's say 3-4 machines are there. I want to run in all those machines. Okay, one is my unit testing machine, one is in my integration testing or system testing machine, one is my acceptance testing machine, or different environments. Okay, you want to execute them and you want to do all of that at the same time. So Grid is that tool which will help you to do that. Grid is that part of Selenium which will run multiple test cases, different test cases you can run across different browsers, operating systems and machines in parallel. If you see the diagram, this is how it looks like. So you'll have a main machine, a hub machine, where you will have all your scripts. Okay, now you'll also have Grid over here. Plus you will do a setup of multiple machines which are attached, which are associated with the hub. These machines are called node machines. Okay, nodes. All the nodes have to be connected to the hub. Now here in the Grid, you will go upload your script. Okay, and then you will mention which node should run on which operating system or whatever. It already be, we already know that which operating system it is. Okay, so node 1 should run in which browser, node 2 will run in Chrome browser, node 3 will run in Internet Explorer. Maybe you can have same script running in all the different browsers at the same time, or you can have 3 different scripts running in 3 different browsers at the same time. Okay, so Grid is basically used for parallel testing. Uses a hub node concept where you run your test on a single machine called a hub, but execution will be done in different machines. This is Arika. A node. See, node is like, suppose you have a tree and the branches to it. Okay, so you have one main machine, that is, let's say I'm the main tester and you are the secondary tester. Let's say I'm primary tester and you are the secondary tester. In a team, how does it work? Okay, so maybe you are working with other team members, or not team members, let's not put it that way. So I'm primary machine, my laptop is primary machine where WebDriver is available. And I have created all the scripts. And your machine is Mac machine. Okay. Yours is secondary machine. And maybe Sushma is there. Okay. And her machine is a Windows machine. Okay. So you both are my node machines. I will connect to both of your machines. Scripts are there in my machine. Okay. Using Grid, I will execute the scripts in mine. I'll click on run button in my machine, which is the hub. But the execution of the test case will take in your machine and in Sushma's machine. You are the nodes, like that. Got it? They're like branches. You're creating a branch. Look at the hub is where all the scripts are available, all the action, all the tasks to be performed are there. And to see the results, you have to go to nodes. This is where the execution will actually happen. Okay. Yes, let me put it here. So what happened is like this.